Hello everyone, today in this tutorial we will discuss about the fault tolerance mode in TIBCO administrator. Basically, fault tolerance is the ability of a system or an application to gracefully cope up with an unexpected situation and continue its service as normal. For applications those are developed and deployed in TIBCO, fault tolerance can be achieved by using multiple machines having primary and secondary relationship. In this tutorial, we'll discuss how we can run our services and process in TIBCO administrator in fault tolerance mode to ensure high availability. So before going ahead, let's create a small process that we can deploy. We will have a simple GMS process. One will be a subscriber process, other one will be a publisher. Publisher will publish a GMS message that would be consumed by the subscriber. So let's set up everything. We have already created publisher and subscriber process. Now we need to add a connection here. I'm adding a GMS connection. So it's time to test the connection whether it is working fine or not. Our connection is working fine. Now we are adding a resource and we are adding a process. GMS to sender. Here again we have to add one more process, and in this process our starter activity will be a JFS queue receiver that will be receiving the message published by our subscriber publisher process. Let's configure the connection and tune it here. Pretty good now. Let's give a sensible name here. And here we can see the message that is published by the publisher process is received by the subscriber process. Now is the time and we should create an archive file. Let's make a folder. Name it as EAR. Go to general, add an enterprise archive here. The enterprise archive, there would be a shared archive. Now we have to add one process archive here. Add the starter process here and add the receiver process here. All the dependent resources have already been added here, so we are good with the archive file here. Let's build our archive now. So now our archive file has been created. Log in to TIBCO admin. Go to application management. Create a new folder. Give the folder name as fault tolerance. You can give any other name, but just to make the things a bit more sensible and to distinguish between different applications, we are giving a sensible name. So at least we can have an idea that what we are trying to do. Open the fault tolerance folder. Click on new application. And now we have to browse the file that we have just created here. That is fault tolerance. Save it. Again, click on this fault tolerance. Go to configuration. Here, on clicking on process archive, you can see one more option, that is add to additional machine. When we click on this, we can get a menu like this. Here, we have to select the machine name and need to click on OK. After doing this, we can see there are two instances for the same archive that we have deployed. Here we have a setting of fault tolerance mode. So if we keep them as peer to peer, it would be like the primaries, the first instance would be running and second will take over as soon as the first one will go down, and other relationship is primary and secondary. So depending on the requirement, you can go with anyone. You can left it as peer to peer. We have to make sure that run fault tolerance has been checked. After this, we have other option like hardware interval, activation interval, and activation delay. So I will explain each and every one. Hardware interval. If we have multiple instances deployed, how the second instance will get to know that the first instance or first server has go down? So when our first instance is running, or we can say when the master is running, it keeps on sending a heartbeat signal to the secondary server, which keeps the secondary server informed that the primary server or master is running well. The moment secondary server stops getting the heartbeat, it is a clear indication that the primary server has gone down and it starts working as a primary server. So for that thing, we have an activation interval. It tells us that how much time would be taken by the secondary server to start itself once the primary server is down. And there is one activation delay. So what activation delay does is if the master server has went down, how much time will it take to make our attempt to come up once again? That delay time between going down and coming up once again is configured using this activation delay. So let's click on apply, click on save here. Click on deploy. Click on OK. So now we can see so we can see here clearly that right now our first instance is running. That I have sent here has been consumed by our first service instance. Okay, this we can confirm by seeing the created process number as 1. Now if you see, if click once again, and we can see the created process has been increase to 3. Now if you see one thing clearly, that all the process, all the messages that we are sending, they are going to this first instance. Now if I kill this one, automatically our secondary server would come up and start acting as a primary server. If you see, the moment it has stopped, our secondary server started to run. Now let's see whether it is receiving the messages or not. And yes, we can see the number of process has been started to has been increased to 3. So we have seen clearly that when the primary server was active, it was receiving the message, and the moment it went down, our secondary server has started and started to receive the messages. So this was the implementation of fault tolerance, and we have seen how it works. I will come up with one more video in which I will show how we can maintain the load balance between two instances. So that was all for now. Keep watching this channel and keep subscribing and keep sharing. Thank you.